everybody, it's David. Welcome back to the channel. I am going to do the Dig a Little Deeper 50 Questions tag that my good friend Beth at Redrum Records uploaded today to her channel. I have done these tags in the past, and they're a lot of fun, and it's just a way to get you out there and let people know a little more about you through some interesting questions. So this one has 50 questions, and without further ado, let's jump on in. All right, so question one. Do you prefer writing with blue or black pen? I'm gonna say that I prefer a black pen. I just think that black ink looks cleaner and it looks more professional. So a black pen. Question two, would you prefer to live in the city or the country? I grew up in the city, albeit not, you know, major cities. But I would actually prefer to live in the country. My best friend in high school, or I guess grade school through high school, lived on a farm with 120 acres. I used to love spending the night at his house. We would, you know, explore the farm, climb trees, shoot BB guns, ride four-wheelers. I just prefer, you know, being kind of away from everybody. It's peaceful. So yeah, I would much prefer to live in the country. Number three, if you could learn a new skill, what would it be? I've always wanted to learn to play the drums. I don't feel like I have the coordination to do so. But yeah, I think the drums would be a fun skill to add to my music arsenal. Question four, do you drink your tea or coffee with sugar? I don't drink coffee at all, but I do prefer my tea to be sweet, my iced tea to be sweet. If I'm drinking hot tea, I don't put a lot of sugar in it. I might add some milk to it and some honey. So definitely some sugar in my sweet tea, iced tea. Question five, what was your favorite book as a child? I always enjoyed the Encyclopedia Brown books. I enjoyed the Ramona the Pest books by Beverly Cleary, and Jack London's Call of the Wild was always a favorite too. Question six, do you prefer baths or showers? I am a shower person. I like to just get in and get out. I feel like a bath is just too much. You know, you have to wait for the tub to fill up and you gotta sit there and soak. And I mean, when I get up in the morning, I hit the shower, it wakes me up and I can start my day. Question seven, if you could be a mythical creature, which would you choose? I would choose to be a gnome. I have just always liked garden gnomes. So yeah, a gnome. Question eight, do you prefer reading paper or electronic books? I'm not really much of a reader these days. So if I were to have to read something, I would probably choose to do it electronically. Number nine, what is your favorite item of clothing? I am a t-shirt and jeans kind of guy, so I would say a t-shirt. 10, do you like your name and would you ever change it? I like my name, but growing up, I definitely would have changed it. I have the same name as my dad, and I always hated being called Little David. You know, if someone called the house and asked for David, the immediate response was Big David or Little David. And I just always hated that. Mom and Dad almost named me Jason, but decided to name me after my dad. So yeah, I would have changed it if I could have, but now that I'm an adult, I like my name. Question number 11, who is a mentor to you? I don't really have a mentor. I have, you know, friends and colleagues at work that I really look up to a lot and respect, but a mentor, I don't really have one per se. Question 12, would you ever want to be famous? If so, what for? I don't know if I would want to be like worldwide famous, but you know, when I was in a band, I liked being on the stage and singing and playing guitar, you know, so if I only had, you know, some notoriety locally, I would be okay with that. So I don't want to be like super famous, but you know, it's nice to be recognized. Question 13, are you a restless sleeper? I am not. When I go to bed, I lay down on my left side and I pretty much wake up still on my left side. So I am not a restless sleeper at all. Question 14, do you consider yourself a romantic? Not as much as I used to be. As you know, I've been married for 20 years. We'll be celebrating 21 years in July. But you know, as life happens, you know, we're busy with our jobs and, you know, personal matters, you know, outside of our core family of my daughter and my daughters and wife. So we're always busy doing something. So when we do have time to ourselves, we don't take advantage of it like we probably should. So I need to work on that, I guess, or we both need to work on that. So I wouldn't consider myself to be as romantic as I used to be. Question 15, which element best represents you? I'll go with water. I really like to swim. Water cleanses. I'm generally a pretty clean guy. All right, next question, 16. Who do you want to be closer to? I don't know if this means closer emotionally or closer like in proximity. I'm gonna go the proximity route and say I would like to be closer to my friend Matt. We graduated high school together. He moved away to Nebraska and he now lives outside of Atlanta. I've gone to visit him a few times since high school. We talk on a fairly regular basis or FaceTime one another, but I wish he was closer or I was closer to him so that, you know, we could see one another in person more frequently. Question 17, do you miss someone at the moment? I can't say that I miss anyone right now. Next month, my family has like an annual badminton tournament. It's named after my grandmother. So yeah, I would like to see my grandmother. You know, it would be nice if she could be there at the tournament that's in her namesake. Question 18, tell us about an early childhood memory. I remember getting a pair of white leather Nikes with the red swoosh. You know, school was starting back and we always got new shoes. And I was really proud of these white Nikes with the red swoosh. And I was running from the kitchen down the hall to my bedroom. And I tripped and landed against the bookcase at the end of the hall. And I ended up having to get like 3 stitches next to my eye And so like the first day of school or the week after school started, I kind of looked like Frankenstein with the black eye and stitches going down my face. So good times. Question 19. What is the strangest thing you have eaten? This is kind of a funny story. I traveled to France for work, and it was in the cafeteria one afternoon that they were selling sandwiches, and it said beef ling, or I didn't know what it was, but it turns out that what I was eating was cow tongue. And you know, taking a bite of your sandwich and feel like it's tasting your back wasn't a very good feeling, so I didn't eat the whole thing. So cow tongue. I also ate snails, which weren't bad. They were actually pretty good. Question 20. What can you see outside your bedroom window? Outside of my bedroom window, I can see Lowe's. I can see Popeyes. I can see the bypass. So, not the greatest view. 21, what are you most thankful for? I am thankful for my wife and daughters. My cat is climbing into a box at the moment and making a lot of noise, so sorry. I'm thankful to be celebrating 21 years of marriage this year. My daughters will turn 20 in August. It's just been great being a husband and a father, and I wouldn't change it for the world. Question 22, do you like spicy food? I do. I love spicy foods. The spicier, the better. 23, have you ever met someone famous? I have. I've been to horror conventions. I've met, you know, some of the celebrities there. I've been to concerts. I was within a few feet of Liam Gallagher of Oasis. I mean, I didn't really meet him per se, but you know, he did walk by and was waving at everybody. I used to work at Best Buy when I was in college, and Kenny Walker, the basketball player, would come in frequently. So I've met Kenny Walker. I've met a lot of the UK basketball players that have, you know, come and gone since college. So I've met a few famous people. Question 24, do you keep a diary or journal? I do not keep a diary or a journal. 25, do you prefer to use pen or pencil? I don't do a lot of handwriting these days, but if I had to, I would prefer a pen. Question 26, what is your star sign? I'm assuming that means my astrological zodiac sign. I am an Aquarius. 27, do you like cereal crunchy or soggy? I prefer my cereal to be crunchy. You know, I maybe kind of a blend of crunchy and soggy. I don't like it so crunchy that it hurts your jaw, but I don't like it so soggy that it's like mush. So kind of that in-between phase. 28, what would you want your legacy to be? I would want my legacy to be that I was a loyal husband, a loyal friend, I'm overall good person, well-liked. 29, do you like reading, and what was the last thing you read? I don't do a lot of reading these days. The last thing I read, though, was Ready Player One, and before that it was the Millennium Trilogy by Stieg Larsson. It's the Girl with the Dragon Tattoo series. So yeah, read some Dan Brown books, Da Vinci Code and Angels and Demons. But yeah, that's some of the last things I've read anyways. Question 30, how do you show someone you love them? I'm not an overly affectionate kind of person. I kiss my wife and hug my wife and hug my daughters and kiss them, but I guess my daughters would say that if I'm quiet, or if I'm, you know, not being a smart aleck or picking on them, then something's wrong. So I guess that's my way of showing affection. Question 31. Do you like ice in your drinks? I don't drink a lot of ice drinks. I typically just drink my Diet Mountain Dew straight out of the can, or I drink from a bottle, plastic bottle. But I guess if I do have ice in it, it's when I go through like a drive-thru. But ice tends to melt and water things down. So, I mean, I'm not opposed to ice, but it's not something that I have to have in my drink. 32, what are you afraid of? As I get older, I don't like heights as much as I used to. And I'm not really a big fan of large crowds. If I feel like I can't move around freely, I start to get a little bit panicked. Question 33, what is your favorite scent? I'm not a coffee drinker, but I like the smell of a freshly brewed batch of coffee, I guess.
Fresh pot!
34, do you address older people by their first or last name? I will typically address my elders as sir, ma'am, Mr., Mrs., unless they tell me otherwise. I'm usually very cordial to people I don't know and to my elders. Question 35, if money wasn't a factor, how would you live your life? I don't think I would live it very much differently. I might drive a nicer car. I don't think I would change a whole lot of things if money wasn't a factor. I'd have more like shelving and stuff, or a bigger space for my vinyl collection and horror collectibles. 36, do you prefer swimming pools or swimming in the ocean? I like swimming in the ocean. I just like playing in the waves. I know, a lot of people either haven't been to the ocean or don't like the ocean because of movies like Jaws, but I actually enjoy playing in the ocean. For not living anywhere close to an ocean, I do like swimming in pools too. 37, what would you do if you found $50 on the ground? If I knew who the money belonged to, I would definitely give it back to them. But if I didn't know who it belonged to, I wouldn't turn it into a service desk, because you know that someone's going to pocket that themselves. So, you know, $50 is $50, so I would probably pocket it, unless I knew who it belonged to otherwise. Question 38. Have you ever seen a shooting star, and did you make a wish? I have seen shooting stars. I did not make a wish. 39. What is one thing you would want to teach your children? I hope that my children have seen how I am towards others. I try to be respectful and very cordial to people that I don't know or I'm meeting for the first time. I just think that's, you know, speaks volumes about a person if they're, you know, polite and welcoming and receiving and all that stuff. So I would hope that they would pick up on that from me and just learn to just do unto others as you would want them to do unto you. Question 40. If you had to have a tattoo, what would it be and where would you get it? I do have tattoos, but I've been wanting to get a tattoo of like Michael Myers and Jason and some of the horror icons that I really like. I think that would be a cool piece to have on my left arm. It's right now my left arm is completely blank. It's a clean slate, so I think that would be cool to have some horror icons on my arm. 41. What can you hear right now? Right now it's just me in the house and the cats. I hear my cat Rhea and the bell on her collar occasionally, and the hum of the refrigerator at the moment. Question 42, where do you feel safest? I feel the safest at home. 43, what is one thing you want to overcome or conquer? I really want to quit smoking. Easier said than done, though. I'm not one that likes to take medication for anything. I mean, it takes a lot for me to take a pill for a headache. So I don't think taking any kind of medication is the route I would want to go. If, for me, it's just gonna have to be cold turkey. But yeah, quitting smoking is a lot easier said than done. 44. If you could travel back to any era, which would you choose? I think that I would like to go back to the 60s and be a teenager. At the time, you know, when the Beatles and the Rolling Stones and bands like Cream and Pink Floyd were hitting it big. 45, what is your most used emoji? The cry laughing emoji. 46, what is your favorite season and why? I prefer the fall. I like the cooler temperatures. You know, that's when the leaves and stuff start to change. I don't have to mow my grass anymore. And it's also when Halloween happens. 47, how would you spend your ideal day? My ideal day is not having anything I have to do. I can listen to records, I can watch a movie, I can just relax and be by myself or spend time with my wife. So yeah, that's my ideal day. 48, describe yourself using one word. I would say chill. Pretty easygoing. 49, what do you regret the most? If I could go back and change anything, I would like to be have been a little more wiser with my money when I was, you know, first starting to make some good money at my job, putting some back and saving more. And the last question, 50, invent your own word. And what does it mean? Invent my own word. Yeah, I don't know how to answer that one. So yeah, I'm gonna call that a pass. So there you have it, folks. 50 questions give you a little more insight as to who I am. I'm not going to tag anyone. If you feel inclined to do this tag, by all means do so. And that's going to do it for this video. Hope you all are doing well. And until next time, take care. Thanks.